Our O gauge model railroad is over 25 years old. We never ever get sick of running it. It features Lionel and Mike's Train House trains and some super custom detailing, a lot of it handmade, constantly updated. It's in an ongoing state of being updated. And our layout was featured in a previous Classic Toy Trains. You can adjust your device and watch this video in full 4K on a widescreen TV. Enjoy the trains. If you look close, you'll see there are just hundreds of little details. There's people in every one of the cars, and the scenery is very realistic. Now, the control line model airplane flying field, I hand carved a lot of those models. I had some donated by friends. I had some of the cars donated by friends, and all the little details, and there's so many little details, even the little crossbucks. The things that you look and you don't see them right away, you look and you see, oh, wow, look at that. There's another little detail. least sometime in every session, we try to run the passenger trains at night. I've had so many nice comments on the video channel, and guys, thanks for the positive comments and supporting the channel, of how much they enjoy the realistic scenery. Now, I try to, whenever I shoot a video of delay, I try to include as many of the little details as I can, and shoot at least some of the footage as if you were the scale size. This is how you would view a train if you were at the train station, in this case, and the seaboard went by. Now, I have to thank my good friend Najat, who is a very professional photographer in every way, helped me get the necessary equipment to detail this layout and camera, of course, and get the whole thing presented in 4K. And here, this view, it almost looks like you're riding in the train opposite it. Big K&W factory that's on the layout is really the chimney to the house that goes right through the middle of the layout. I had to work around that. All the windows are molded from one mold that I made, and all of the little people on the loading dock and the unloading dock, and we usually use this for lashing up trains in the beginning or the end of some of the videos. The scenes, what I've used is an airbrush to detail the track work and to on the roofs of the buildings, just make them just a little more realistic. I try to personalize some of the buildings. This building is dedicated to my late machine shop partner, Joe Cassie, and I think it adds a nice little personal dimension to the layout. anytime I try to create a scene or a train or anything, I try to always include a few people, a nice detail touch. And every little scene on the railroad is different. There's some people digging holes, dogs. We have some animals on the layout. Some people that look like they're playing checkers and various things. Now, another thing that's part of every operating session, I like to do a lot of switching. All of the switches on this are air powered. And we have a compressor under the table that runs all the switches. A really nice system. And it just adds a little bit of realism to a running session. All of the lighting in the layout room is on dimmer switches, so I can gradually make it late in the afternoon or night or totally dark, which I always like to do, especially if I'm running the passenger train in that session. All the details in the coal yard and the big coal unloader, all made from basswood and balsa wood, and of course plenty of people. my grandson Miles has always had a lot of fun with the trains. He's got his own trains since he was about 3 years old, and he loves running the trains at night. I've no idea why. We can never get through a session without, "Turn the lights down, Grandpa, turn them down." And during the night part of this session, Karen brought up some nice fresh cookies for us. When my grandson Miles was growing up, we spent endless hours running his trains in the cellar. He has four sets of trains. Then we'd go up to the attic, run my trains, the big layout. And we've shared that passion for many, many years as he's grown up. And I hope you've enjoyed the video. I hope you have the same passion that I have for model railroading. And thanks so much, so much for watching.